Hello everyone and welcome back to Code with the Italians. Today we are flying solo. Can you say you can fly, you're flying solo if it's two people? Does it work that way?
Yeah.
I have no idea.
Maybe. As a,
I'm out of focus.
As a team, I don't know. also.
But yeah, we don't.
Yeah, so no guest.
We don't have a guest today.
Hi,
we don't have a guest. Hi, well, we were supposed to have a guest, but they've canceled for the third time. I don't think they're coming.
anytime soon.
Yeah, not anytime soon. And so today, what we are doing instead is something that we haven't done for at least a week at this point, which is, you know, actually writing some code.
Coding.
I'm actually happy about
it's
this.
Supposed to be, yeah.
I'm actually happy about this.
It's in the title of the stream.
So yeah, it might be a slightly shorter episode than usual, because both Ivan and myself have had a hell of a day and we are dead tired.
Yeah, this is the usual Red Bull. Here you go.
That's your piss, yeah. Isn't it?
No, it's still Red Bull. I mean, so this is Red Bull. Okay, so look at the color. So do you now understand why Red Bull comes in a non-transparent glass bottle, right? So do you understand
yeah.
that?
Okay? Yeah.
So just food for thoughts. Hi, Mark, how you doing? No, actually, Spike, well, Spike is in the Spike corner. Well, in the Spike corner, we have the champion. I don't know if you can
no,
see.
No, it's out of the frame.
Here you go. Probably you can see now
yep.
somehow. So it's in the corner there because we have guests at home and guests are Spike favorite toys. So if there's somebody in the other room, Spike is gonna be at the door trying to go on the other side. On the other hand, there is also my baby. Crying, so I want to give my wife a break and keeping the dog here. So
I just realized, is the baby crying because of your guest or?
No, it's actually today. No, I mean the guest is mostly working during the day, so it's a very low maintenance. Well, it's one of those low maintenance guests. So it's
perfect kind of guest. Favorite. Yeah,
yeah, that's my favorite kind of guests. But no, the baby is just one of those days, you know, you never calms down, you know, probably it's like, you know, I don't know, probably it, I don't know, belly ache. I don't know if it's some, if it's even English, but
I don't think so.
you get the point. Whatever. So, I mean, he only eats milk. So, you know, at some point it gets to you, you know,
yeah.
From a digestive point of view. So today, something that we have a few things to actually put on the table. We have the usual giveaway for the stickers. As you can see, the stickers actually look at this. You know, we are running out of stickers now. We
ouch.
Are not. We already bought another batch, so they're coming. But you know, we are giving away stickers, and we are giving away a ticket for DroidCon Turin, right,
yeah.
Sebastian?
Yeah, Turin. Because we ran out of tickets for London and for Berlin. But we still have the ones for DroidCon Italy, which, contrary yes. to the other two, is actually going to be online. So you don't need to travel there. Pros and cons, I guess.
Yes, and this is...
Mm-hmm. And DroidCon Italy is on the 12th and 13th of November, I seem to remember. Maybe put a link in the chat just in case.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just gonna grab a link here. So I can give people the right information. They can decide if they want to participate to the giveaway, because we had, unfortunately, you know, people that that won the ticket, but they couldn't travel. So we re-rolled a couple of times the tickets. Apparently, DroidCon website is not loading. Anyway, I'm just gonna try to put the link here. Here you go. So just check out the Seb audio and video is a little out of sync. Ivan is fine. Okay.
I don't know what to do about that.
I mean, well, let's try to
let me roll let me and, try and do.
And
this, maybe.
And at the end of, I mean, later during the stream, we are also announcing the the next. Speak. Yeah.
That's a good idea. Like, I'll do like, that.
So it's like the, I don't know if some of you watched Squid Game.
I'm watching it.
Yeah, and a couple of friends, they tried to watch it with English dubbing. Is it dubbing in English?
Yeah.
Is it English?
I'm watching it with the English dub. It's terrible. It's like, it's seriously, I don't know the words to use that I can actually say publicly, but I've never seen terrible dub in my life.
Yeah,
it's ghastly.
Because, but actually, it's a thing because Korean is incredibly difficult to dub. So if you think about Italian, there is no Italian version on Netflix, and we are literally dubbing everything. And we gave up. We gave up. We went for straight for subs. And apparently, if you watch it with English subs, but the not the closed caption ones, it's bearable.
Yeah, the closed captions are language and transcribing the English dub, which is weird. Like the subtitles. So closed captioning is for hearing impaired. So it's literally the same thing they're saying in the audio. The subtitles are from the Korean version, so they're translated better because they don't have to do adaptation to the timing of the speaking. I want to say though that the thing that to me, like, I don't speak Korean, so I don't know if what they're saying in the dub makes sense or not. But what I can tell is that the acting is terrible. Someone told someone the brief was probably something like, "Oh, you know, Resident Evil. You remember the dubbing of Resident Evil? That's the level I want. That's what I'm aiming for." I don't know why you would do that. Like, do you remember the original Resident Evil game on PlayStation where everyone was like, "Oh no, we need to do something now."
Yes.
That sort of thing.
That's not easy to do. Anyway, just to sum up, we have also a new project coming in the next few weeks, and we are going to announce it during the show. So stay with us, bear with us. And so from a code perspective, Sebastiano, I would like to I would like to thank one of our users because we got a couple of pull requests.
Yeah,
and we got also
let me share the screen
issues. Yeah, please.
Okay,
so until now our GitHub was mostly kind of not used. So it's just Sebastiano pushing to main and YOLO, like the usual shenanigans, right? We're not doing any. But a few days ago, last week to be precise, one of our users, one of our watchers, followers, subscribers, they started to contribute. And And yes, yes. If you're looking at the chat, there is somebody asking who's gonna be our next guest from on Sunday.
Yeah, but Mark is cheating because he knows.
Yeah, Mark knows. Yeah. Anyway, back to the GitHub thing. So being bundled an open source project, they can contribute, right? So they were able to, first of all, point out that we can't hilt. We don't know how to hilt. So they fixed something in the dependency injection setup that we have. And
I may be a troll, and they were also
they also went for some minor refactoring, and they also open an issue or two.
One.
If I'm not wrong, yeah. One issue. So apparently there is a crash in the app, and this is not happening while we build the app.
It's never happened to us.
It's not happening on the emulator.
That's for sure.
So it's not happening on the emulator that Sebastiano is running, but it's happening on their device or the emulator. So something that we can try to do, because we also have how to reproduce it, that's incredibly nice. We can probably try to fix it, Sebastiano. What do you think?
I think that I don't remember exactly what the problem is, but I want to fix it because it's been there for a week.
Yep.
Because we haven't really done much coding in the past week. But I think it's worth fixing it before we actually go into the nitty-gritty of the setting screen and finishing up all those things that we said a few weeks ago that we would do, and then we got slightly sidetracked by having some very awesome guests coming over. So, speaking of guests, I think it's fair to say, obviously, the guest we're going to have on Sunday is our friend and favorite troll, which is Mark. So, yeah, we're looking forward to having Mark with us.
Oh, my God, Mark is coming. Mark is coming.
Mark is coming. Yeah, yeah. I know it's the first time. It's an exclusive. It's never happened before, but Mark is coming to help us.
I'm pretty sure we are going to work on the database, right?
No UI with Mark. We don't do UI stuff with Mark.
No UI, no animation, no fanciness.
Oh, yes, ciao Pietro.
Pietro, caramba. nobody actually saw it coming. Oh my God, yeah, for the first time we are going to have Mark Alisa. But jokes aside, I really look forward because I'm not like the super UI expert, so I always learn cool things.
If only there was a way for you to learn about how to create UIs. Spoilers. I'm sorry, I'm super excited at the announcement that we're gonna do later, so I'm just I can't say everything now. I'm not gonna shut up. Besides Mark, we also have some pretty good guests that you probably have heard of before in planned for November. We don't have firm dates yet, so no announcements, but I think you can expect let's say a couple. Iron Man and a Spaniard that doesn't sound Spaniard, probably.
Fair enough. So it's a bit vague, but it's just a teasing thing.
Yeah.
And I want to make it clear, we did it already in the past and we mean it. If you want to come. So if you want to give it a shot, if you think that you can bring something to the show, if you have, I don't know, if you wrote a blog post about Compose, if we want to try, if you think that something that you worked out in one of your projects could fit bundle and you want to try it live, just let us know, because we can We can give it a try, give it a thought, and maybe we can have you as a guest on one of our episodes. So just consider the show has the repo itself. If you want to contribute, open a PR. If you want to come to the show, just send us a message, and we will try to make it happen. So what's with the crash?
Okay, so I was rereading this.
So null pointer exception.
Null pointer exception in getString.
Okay.
So it looks like in this function, when we do getString here on settings.secure, the enabled notification listener secure setting might not be set, which to me it's weird, because that's one of the like the settings.secure, the settings.secure accesses stuff that is documented for the most part. It's stuff in the OS settings. So the only way in which that might be not working is if there's anything like maybe the emulator has just been created and the setting hasn't been created yet. I don't know. That seems like a very weird thing to have, but
so. But it's not happening, because actually now I'm looking at the description. Yeah. They are also using an emulator with Windows 10, and basically it's the same machine that you have, right?
That's why it's weird to me, because it's like Windows 10 on an API 30 emulator. That's what I'm using. I wouldn't expect this to happen. What they didn't specify is the emulator image they're using. If they're using the AOSP one, if they're using the Google Play one, if they're using Google API one, so we can try that.
Suggesting
I don't know if that's gonna make much of a difference.
If we have, they are suggesting a couple of things on the on the chat. If we have a version with a default value,
let's actually go to the code.
Yeah, let's go to the code. To the code. Yeah, we need more. We need more sounds.
Yeah, but we also need not to get demonetized or sued. So yeah, there isn't unfortunately a version of getString that returns.
So where is the crash? It's like line 9. So you. So that's the line, right?
Line 9. That stuff hasn't been changed in the past week. And if you look the change they're suggesting is this, essentially, which makes sense, is if the whatever this returns is null, then enable listener is null, which is fine. That's pretty much how I would have fixed it as well. So what we can do is we can do this. I think this works.
Yeah.
I am never sure.
Dark Kali is suggesting, just out of curiosity, if you can control click the get string to see,
but the problem is
have the source code.
They're out now. That's
quite a connection, Sebastiano. Lucky you.
That dude, that's like 40 megabits, 50 if I'm lucky.
Yeah, that's 40 megabits more than I get.
Fair enough.
Welcome, Klaus.
Welcome.
So
I'm surprised that the download button actually worked for once.
Yeah, the refresh button never works, by the way.
Yeah.
Try again.
Yeah. Get string
okay.
for you.
So do we have like null if not present? Okay. There was like null if not present. So they don't find the string.
Yeah, the string is not there, simply. That's the problem. And
setting whatever has moved. No, that's a warning.
Yeah, those are like things they let you know.
Deprecation and stuff.
Well, probably. it's a way to tell you that whatever you're trying to access, it's not there where you're looking for it anymore. But it's just logging stuff. It doesn't really matter.
Mm.
Like lock settings. I don't even know what this is.
The split was causing the null pointer exception. That's probably...
But yeah, I mean,
that's probably...
it's this, pretty much. It's a cache.
Get string.
Like, it's
you.
A map.
Mm-hmm.
And if there is no value there, it's going to return null.
So we have an issue, just to give an update. We have an issue from one of our users on GitHub, because the app is crashing on their machine and they suggested a fix. Now we are looking into the crash, because we can't crash the app, but apparently there is a scenario where for some reason the get string that you see at line 9 returns a null. So when you dot split on a null, the whole thing blows up. The unfortunate part is that I think that there is no annotation on the get string, right? Because otherwise Kotlin
there is no annotation.
Will know. So that's so what are you doing, Sebastian?
It's fine. I just want to test that this actually does what I think it does. So
okay. So for those that don't know, Sebastiano is using a Scratch file. A Scratch file is something that you can access in Android Studio in IntelliJ to just start coding in. It's like, you can imagine, like, you know, if you will use Notepad.
Yeah, it's
in
a playground.
A way, but it's a playground, but if you enable this checkbox that you see at the top, interactive mode, on the right side of the screen, you have this panel that constantly compiles Kotlin and evaluates whatever you type. So it can be very, very useful to prototype things, especially if you're building, like, you know, a tiny function and you don't want to write tests because... you really don't want to type tests, so you can.
So
how to enable it?
How to enable it?
The usual thing that I do is Control Shift A.
Yeah.
And I type Scratch.
Oh, sorry. No, that's the REPL. Yeah, it's wrong. But yeah, to create a Scratch file, you can do. Well, you see the shortcuts down there.
Control Alt Shift, whatever.
I don't even know. But yeah, the idea is that you, I have weird shortcuts set up, but.
Okay.
So I'll just put this in the chat.
In the chat.
There you go. And
you.
The idea is that Scratch files are kind of like files that are not part of the project. They are just files you have on your local file system, and they will be shared across projects because they're not really part of the project. And in fact, they show down here in the Scratches and Consoles part in the project view. I don't know if the Android view shows them. No, it doesn't. One more reason not to use that. But
brutal.
Well, you should say fair. No, it's not iced coffee.
Yeah, it's piss.
Yeah. Sorry, I mean Red Bull.
Red Bull. It's Red Bull. Yeah, such an idiot. Anyway,
me?
And by the way, no, we are not increasing the font. Stop asking.
Like, I would increase the font, but then literally nothing fits on screen. Like, it's what, 30 lines that we can keep on screen right now? It becomes very complicated.
I don't know.
If I increase it more. Like,
Let's try. I just want to. Is it?
It's already 19. I would struggle.
But that's not the editor one.
Yeah.
Is it the editor
one?
Yeah,
it's the editor one. I can make it this big if you prefer. Okay. Ivan, yeah, time for a poll. Time for a poll. 19 or 20?
Okay. Let's
consider that this
19,
is
wow,
the usual.
Or 20. Okay.
Like, this is the usual scenario. So the more that the font increases, the less shit you see. So okay. This is best case. This is real world. So okay. So yeah, what I was doing here, I was checking that my list is empty true when the list is null. And it actually tells me it is not null, which is a problem because I want this to return when that's null. I could have also looked at the fact that the compiler was complaining. That also would have told me, but I just wanted to show off. The bigger the font, the less bugs we can see. I don't know, Mark. I think the problem is that when you see a bug, you see it very, very big. So I don't know. It's a compromise there. It's the frequency versus the space it takes on screen. Okay, so yeah, I just wanted to show that Scratch files exist and they're super useful. I don't think, no, there isn't the HTTP client in Android Studio, unfortunately. But if you have IntelliJ Ultimate, I think, there's also built-in HTTP client, which is super handy. You don't need to use Postman or curl or whatever. Well, you can just use that. You just write the request there. Yeah, I think by episode 100, we're going to be at font size 30 or something. Yeah. I will need an 8K screen at that point.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you for the cheers.
Okay. Thank you.
So what we need to do is making it explicit. And then that should fix it.
Also, I'll enter. Why is telling you twice? Simplify. Because you can simplify two of them and probably it's just piling them.
Yeah, anyway, probably.
So this is true work.
I think that's fixing the bug. I mean, it is pretty much the same thing that Ali was saying on the issue. It's pretty much, it is exactly the same thing, like this and this.
Nice.
So it is the same fix. And I think that's all there is to it.
Fantastic. Okay, so considering that we can't even test it, ship it. Ship it so we can actually ask our people if they can reproduce it. So about that, Sebastiano, I was thinking, do we want to start publishing the app? Like even in like internal alpha track? And have people from the stream installing the app.
That's not a bad idea. I think we could do that. Maybe we can get someone help us with the publishing process.
The action.
Would you folks be interested? Like if we ask someone, maybe from Google, if they can help us with the Play Store listing.
Yeah, I mean, because I'm pretty sure that both of us, we have the Play Store accounts, so we can even create another account for Code with Italians if we plan to have more than one app. But it would be nice to even have an episode, you know, where we set up the CI, we show how to create I don't know, the like a delivery, you know, like a deployment pipeline. Every time you merge on main, you get a new build. Oh, yeah.
But you can set up the Play Store, that stuff, kind of stuff fairly quickly. Just need a Gradle plugin and GitHub Action. That should be fine. Okay. I think the interesting part on the CI side, I think one thing I would like to do is I would like to get someone that explains to me how to make the CI run the UI tests, because currently they're not run but I don't know, there was someone from that was saying that they would look into it. I don't know, I'll ping them, I'll see.
Bitrise, they can definitely do it. Hi, everything okay?
Yep.
What are you doing?
Hi, Sasha.
Just finished the call.
Come, Sasha, come. So we have a cameo. Hey. So this is the guest. So this is the guest, and you don't see, but there is the dog, you know, dog here, yes. Here, just because, you know, the toy just came into the room. So
I'm also gonna be his dinner in like half an hour or so.
Yeah, probably. So we were discussing actually running test UI tests on the CI, Sasha, and you use Bitrise for that,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, because Bitrise is easy to set up for the UI test instances, right? So I have to say I didn't have much time to play with GitHub Actions, but Bitrise was ready to set up.
So with Bitrise, so with GitHub Actions, we are actually running them on Firebase. So we are running on Firebase Test Lab.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's fairly straightforward. You know, there is just a bit of Google Cloud machinery that you need to set up, but it's pretty straightforward. And you have like a, updating place.
Yeah, don't support. Worry. It works.
Yeah, it means that it works. You get a live notification on the emulator. But for Test Lab, for Firebase Test Lab, you have like a quota of, you know, like a handful of run that you can do for free. But it's pretty legit. Otherwise, we can try Bitrise. Bitrise also they have a free tier, so it shouldn't be problematic. But
one nice thing about Bitrise is that they have this robo runner, right? So basically, it's like a crawl that goes through the app. So it basically just goes through every screen and presses everything that it can, right?
I do the same with Test Lab. So okay. they have this robo.
The monkey.
It's not an instrumentation, but it's a smarter version of monkey. Okay. So you can even run it locally. I can look it up, the link. You get it on developerandroid.com. It's called App Crawler. And it's like the old monkey, but it's more like a smarter version, because the old monkey is just throwing events at you, right? Mm. So the whole thing is just clicking like a crazy thing. Robo tests are more like you can even feed him, for instance, like a login and password kind of thing, right? If you have a login screen, you can specify the ID of the to edit text, and it's gonna fill in the login information to actually bypass the login screen. So it's quite smart.
That's cool.
And it's absolutely free. And you know, the thing is, it finds the weirdest shit. You know, it finds those, because it's also clicking very fast, right? So it's also creating those scenarios when you know, if you click twice in a half a millisecond on the same thing. I don't know, like a network call, two network call go. So it's interesting.
Yeah, I think one of the differences is that Monkey sends system events, right? Yeah. So you have volume up, volume down, camera, that sort of stuff. I'm not sure if Robo does this. Robo is kind of more intelligent and it's more systematic, because it literally goes and presses everything, right? Yeah. So it won't miss anything. So if you have a crash if you press the this button is going to find it, yeah. Right? Whereas Monkey, you never know.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, Monkey is more kind of random, so you never know. Like you might discover something you didn't know crashes.
So and they are free, so we can, yeah, sure. We can definitely look into it.
Yeah, sure. I literally
anything else?
What I literally don't know. Yeah, mm-hmm. There's a question from Raul.
So what is it?
What do we have? So what's a content resolver on 9-line? Sebastiano, yep. Content resolver on 9-line.
Switch back to sharing the screen because it was easier to see people while you were talking. So line 9, yeah. It's this. So a content resolver is a content resolver.
Yeah. Wow. Thank you.
Documentation. Essentially, a content resolver is a thing that you use to read data from a content provider, pretty much. Let's just say, vaguely speaking, that's how that works.
So what's a content provider?
A content Sebastian? Provider is something you'd never want to have to implement yourself.
Yeah.
Unless you really hate your life.
What's the context?
And want to end it.
Yeah.
It's content provider is something that is a native Android paradigm to share data across different processes. So it's essentially a local public API to exchange data between your app and another app. So if I know that you have like your the Contacts app, for example, I can use a content provider that is documented, so I know the URL for it and I know how the data looks, and I can say, hey, I want the data from this URL, which is then resolved to your app, which is the Contacts app, and then I can query it as if it were a database or other different kinds of it's a local public API for local people. Yes. Hey, Sasha. you can actually hear.
No, I was just wondering, like, it's strange. It's like hearing one side of telephone conversation, right? So you just know something's going on, but you have no idea why.
So I was like, there is something off in this thing, right? What's off? What's off? Oh yeah, Sasha does not have earphones. Oh, fuck.
So, I was wondering if you had put on speaker or something.
No, I was just I'm just gonna sip another sip of Red Bull. Probably is gonna help.
Wake up juice.
Yeah, maybe you should bring another can or.
Yeah, but I like, for instance, what Mark is saying about his setup. So we had already like a sneak peek in his setup a few weeks ago. He is running like he has a small server also to run remote builds when he works. And what he's doing is something that you can do. You can definitely do it with GitLab, but I think you can do it also with GitHub Actions. So you can have a local runner,
yep,
on one machine that you own. So you push to GitHub and they trigger the build on your actually local runner for local people, for local builds. And you can plug a device. So this is unusual for Android developers because usually the cloud setups is super cheap, but it's very common for the iOS people. For instance, mm-hmm, the team that I'm working with, they have a Mac Mini with this setup because to have iOS builds on GitHub Action, for instance, is 10 times more expensive than Android, like literally 10 times. So they were like, and their builds are like a million hours. I know.
It takes like half an hour to make a build. Yeah.
They have like a gigantic build time, and so it was getting very expensive. So now they have a different setup. So it's cheaper to buy a Mac Mini and have it there than pay for the cloud. So
yep.
But I like the idea that you can plug a real device and have it running on a real device.
Yeah, so that's how we did go through a few of those, if you remember, right? Because we did have a local GitLab runner on a computer that I had at my home. And then in Chattermill, we had a local Jenkins server, but then it was a pain to maintain. And then we switched to BuildKite, where you can also have local runners. So I think there are lots of services like this. I'm not sure about Bitrise, but yeah, GitLab offers it. GitHub.
I think GitHub Bitrise, Actions, so. You can do the same with the GitHub Actions. So that's that's also nice.
And if you have a Mac, then you can build both Android and iOS.
Also that. Yeah, people that have plenty of time. You know, when I was in Clue, there was Chris was doing the Jenkins setup and maintenance. So if you have somebody that actually does it willingly or like with joy, that's Jenkins is an incredible tool. If not, it just becomes like very, you know, you end up with the mentor kind of thing very quickly, sucking the joy out of you because you want to do other things.
Yeah, and Jenkins does require quite a lot of maintenance, especially because I remember when I was in Novoda, there was the CI was Jenkins, and there was pretty much every week at least an hour to spend updating Jenkins, updating the various plugins that had security issues, and so on and so forth. So that was
That's why I also moved away from Jenkins, because especially when they introduced those new build pipelines, so lots of the things, lots of plugins didn't get ported.
Yeah.
One thing that I personally liked was the test plugin, right? So it would basically read the test reports and then it would show you a nice graph and show you how it's going. That didn't work. And then I think also the UI test plugin didn't work for Android.
Chris, I think it took a moment to port it.
Yeah, but then it was just like, as Seb says, it was just too much work. And like even with BuildKite or something, you just have to install a machine and they had auto-updating or anything. So
YOLO.
Every now and then you have to update the iOS, the macOS, but then that's it.
On the plus side, it's generally much faster than running any cloud CI.
Oh, yeah. I mean, usually the virtual whatever machine, micro machine that they give you is like an Arduino running Gradle. So, but, you know, you can just give it a shot and then trade off. Sebastian.
Yes.
Show me some Compose, please, because I'm craving Compose.
You're craving Compose. No, I'm serious. Okay, let me commit.
No, I'm working because I have been working on one screen for a couple of days now. There is a lot of state, so I'm like, you know, switching layouts, updating cards in place, and everything is just switching, like, you know, pum, pum, pum. And I was like, okay, you know, I remember the conversation we had with chat, and I'm going to try to do animate layout changes equal true. And man, I can't do that. You know, I do exactly what you say, and nothing works because that's me. You know, that's me versus animations. So that's the even versus animations. What's gonna desabotage? Hi, desabotage.
We'll see. We'll keep an eye on them.
Yeah. Yeah, just welcome, but don't push it. Like, literally. I'm not in the mood.
We don't have weird commands, so.
Okay. I have to go because I have actually other meetings, so I know.
Jesus, Sasha, you should. Okay.
You know, I didn't have meetings today at all.
Uh-huh.
I didn't have any scheduled meetings, but.
So impromptu meeting.
Yes.
So
I'm going to give you back the. So you mentioned that there was some big announcement. Did you already say the announcement?
It's going to be later. It's going to be in a while, so don't miss it.
Well, I don't know. Maybe I can, you know, I have some backwater ways to find out about it.
It's back channels.
Yes, exactly. Anyway.
Enjoy your meeting.
Thanks.
You should stop working at some point, Sasha.
Also, I'm going to steal your dog, you know.
Yeah, the dog is coming with you. I mean, no matter what.
Bye, everyone.
Ciao. People, if you are watching us because your workday ended 1 hour ago, feel lucky.
Yeah.
Because that's what sea level looks like. You know, that's so if you ever think, oh yeah, I'm gonna just make a career out of this, I want to be a CTO. Yeah, that's a CTO. So we are fucking around on Twitch and he's going back to meetings.
Yay.
So you know, just pick your you know, that's and I don't know, maybe he's gonna get a Tesla at some point, but you know, you never know.
I mean, he's more likely to get a Tesla than we are, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Okay.
Anyway.
Yeah. I just wanted to show something that many people don't know about GitHub. That is, hi Hugo. That is very cool, which is you can in pull requests and in commits, you can have a specific text thing that actually does something when the commit is pushed or when that PR is merged. For example, for commits, you can say this commit fixes issue number 18. And it will automatically close it whenever you push it.
That's actually very nice.
So,
and something that I'm have been using, because we are talking about commits and things from Android Studio /IntelliJ. I don't know if Android Studio has it, but you can access pull requests from IntelliJ. Can you do it also on Android Studio?
It's in IntelliJ community, so it's there, but there's no open pull request.
Okay.
But I can...
There are no pull requests.
I mean, I can, yeah.
Yeah. So this is super useful, and I have been using it for a while now. And it's getting better and better over time. It's super nice, especially, you know, to create the pull request. It's an integrated development environment. So it makes sense that the stuff is integrated.
That's very nice, especially if you are not familiar with the code, because then you can just look at the code in the IDE and you can actually control click to stuff, which is fairly useful. Which you definitely cannot do on GitHub itself. So recommended.
Yeah.
I don't always remember to use it, but when I do, I really love it.
It's like
force
the
of habit.
You're like the
force of habit.
I don't usually use it, but when I do.
Yes.
Anyway, I just want to IntelliJ. I just want to get the link for the scratch files that you used before and put it in the episode notes. So people on YouTube, we are going to keep track of it, because if you haven't noticed, every video that we post on YouTube and Twitch, it comes with a description. And in the description, we usually add links that we shared in the chat or things that you know were relevant when we started when we talked about it. So if you have, you know, a link in the chat that you think you're gonna miss, probably you're gonna find it in the description. And if you have an old video, an episode that you remember, oh, there was that thing, it was cool, I can't remember what minute, chances are that it's in the description. We are also starting to add markers on the stream. I don't know how they translate to YouTube. Fair, it's like a honest thing. I need to look into it.
Yeah.
But again, we want to make very smooth to actually also go back to VODs. So markers could be I'll help. Anyway, Sebastian, thank you for bearing with me. Where are we?
So I think there's one thing that we have. Well, there's two things that I want to do, and we have about half an hour. So I say it's perfect timing, unless I fuck everything up, which it might happen. but one thing we need to do is the license screen. Currently, we're just gonna have a dummy screen. It doesn't need to do anything, but we can start, creating it at least and stop making the app crash. And the other thing that we need to do, is currently this screen doesn't have scaffolding,
a toolbar,
which we should probably
have a toolbar or whatever.
Probably put there.
Okay.
Let's
go with the scaffolding. What do you think?
Yeah.
At least it's a more like a UI thing.
I mean, they're both, but sure. But I would say...
Well, I mean, if we go with the scaffolding, we also need to bring the scaffolding to the new screen, right? So we can copy-paste.
Yeah, I mean, the scaffold is going to take, what, 2 minutes? But that's a good time to say we should do the giveaway. And while the giveaway runs, we'll implement the scaffold. And when we're done with the scaffold, then we pick someone. Does it work?
It works. It works. So let's say. The giveaway is gonna be.
DroidCon Italy plus stickers.
It's for DroidCon,
right?
DroidCon Italy plus stickers. So let's see if I can pick a nice word.
Gorgonzola.
Let's go with Turin. Let's go with Gorgonzola.
We always do food. Let's keep the food theme. I think it's something everyone can enjoy. Well, maybe not everyone enjoys Gorgonzola, but I do, so you're wrong.
No, I don't, but my wife does. So it's half of the family, so it's okay. Yeah. So if you want a free ticket for DroidCon Turin, go for it and type Gorgonzola. So I remember.
Thank you for the cheer, by the way.
I want to remind you that. Yes. So Gorgonzola is a cheese. it's a very peculiar cheese. So something that I want to remind you is that DroidCon Italy is not in real life, so it's gonna be live streamed, and being live streamed, it's gonna be
everyone can attend. That's essentially what it means. the only thing might be time zones, but apart from that,
it's gonna be held in Italy, so the time zone is gonna be like Central Europe summertime.
Well, I don't think in November is summertime still, but
Rome. If you are like Rome, Berlin, Madrid, Paris, that's the time zone that you need to look it up. It's like London plus one.
Yeah,
I think London plus one.
Amsterdam. Amsterdam, yes, right?
It's gonna be online, so you're just gonna be there.
Scaffold time.
Go for it. The timer is running anyway. So.
Oh no! What did I do to myself?
I mean, you just go.
Yeah. Oh God. I am going to... Should I copy-paste it? Well, I need to copy-paste at least the up bar. Because it's the same. I can actually do this. I'll just put here the text. Paste text. There is a title. Boom, so I can reuse that and it will look less terrible. Okay. Update. Boom, done. We only have one Gorgonzola for now, guy. Come on. Thank you, Hugo. It's also an Amsterdam time, so you better fucking do it. Okay.
Yeah.
So we need to take a scaffold. That needs a modifier to fit the width of the screen. Not padding, of course. Fill max width. Does it need other shit? It needs the top up bar. I don't think it needs a state particularly. top bar is references, top bar, yeah. And the title here is get string. I mean, there's supposed to be arguments to that. This, and this is r dot string dot excluded up. Well, settings excluded apps title. Okay, and I'll create that. Okay, what is this complaining about? I have imported the wrong thing. Also because this is string resource. No surprise it didn't work.
Okay. Yeah, I mean,
no surprise there.
Old habits die hard, yep. My friend.
Wait.
Oh, let's not forget that Mark bought a variable.
Mark
so...
bought a variable? When?
Yeah.
When?
5 minutes ago.
I missed it. Absent friends. Okay. Fair enough. I do think we're pretty much done. We're missing the on click though. So let's actually do this. On back press. And then we do whatever the fuck, how it worked, I don't remember. Da 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 on back press, just pass it in. Just pass it in. This here. Okay.
Cool.
On back press. Perfect.
Domino's chocolate in Italy. I'm not familiar with Domino's chocolate.
Never heard of it.
Domino's chocolate. No.
Okay, so now what we need to...
No, that makes pizza.
We have Domino's pizza, but that's a different thing. Fairly different thing. Also, I recently found out they've reduced their menu considerably this month, and I hate it. They took away all the good ingredients.
Why?
One of the few good ones that they have left is... Surprisingly enough, gorgonzola. I mean...
Nice. Okay, so what's candy blog?
Candy blog?
What's a... I don't know. Schulte Dominos. German treat. Yeah, it's a German treat that I see in the United States, blah, blah, blah. No, I don't... think we have it. I mean, probably we have it, but it's not something that they will say, oh yeah, that's something Italian.
I honestly don't know.
But no.
Let me see. I haven't seen this.
Really.
Schulte, no. Marzipan, chocolate, and something. I mean, we have marzipan things, but not with this thing at the bottom, I don't think. Anyway. That's what we eat from now to the end of February.
Go,
I mean,
go for
if
it.
You want to send some, I won't Jesus. Complain.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying. Yeah, you can ship everything to Code with Italian PO
Box. 1234 Pizza Avenue.
We need to. Yeah, we need to set up something like, you know, or you can call us to 555 Code with Italians.
Okay, by the way, if it works, it's time to do the raffle. If it doesn't work, then...
Yeah.
Yeah, it works. Boom. Done.
Oh, look at that. Nice. You always look surprised, Sebastian, when you build
Shouldn't
this.
I?
I love it. No, that's perfect. So, we have a few people on the giveaway. Let's run it. Roll 3, 2, 1, boom.
Oh, and congrats, Hugo.
Hugo.
You can send Stroopwafel if you want. This is gonna be getting fat with the Italians very soon.
Oh yeah, no, don't. Yeah, that's don't do that. Don't do that. I mean, those are like criminal. I can't do that. I mean, I can eat like a million. Like, yeah, it's bad for me. And sugar is a bad thing for me. Okay, DroidCon.
By the way, Ivan, how Turin. Many tickets did we have?
Here you go, my friend.
Because I don't remember. Was it mm-hmm. one?
For Turin, okay. I think it was three. Okay. Let me check. Okay, so DroidCon was very generous with us, and we got tickets for like a bunch of places. So we have three tickets that are 100% discount code, and we also have a code for 20%.
You want to share the code discount. For everyone
so
else?
The 20% discount. Oh yeah, I mean, I was planning to share the code after we finished with the. You know, we didn't have any more free tickets, but if you want, I can give you the code right now. So. If you want to get right now 20% off ticket for DroidCon Italy, let me place it as a nice message so we can have it also on the chat on YouTube. DroidCon Italy 2021. Where did the year go, Sebastian?
Is
it's
it?
Already October.
Oh, fuck
me.
Fuck, yeah.
20% off code. Here you go. I love you so much, my friend. This makes I love it. Anyway, if you want a slightly cheaper ticket for DroidCon Italy, that's the 20% off code. Enjoy, and thank you again to DroidCon for being so generous with us and with our viewers. Yeah, that's very relaxing indeed.
So
Sebastian,
I have
where
submitted
are we?
The changes, and I was looking if I have some discount codes for DroidCon London, because I seem to remember that I do.
Something, I think there was something. Oh, did you name
not
the
yet, so because we haven't created a variable, so that's kind of the problem.
Why you are so functional, Bastiano. Variables are for weak people. You're just functions, returning functions, taking functions as parameters, and like everything is a function, man. Everything, monads everywhere. Like monads everywhere. Yeah, actually, I can't remember if we have something also for
London.
I do.
I found the link, and I'm going to put it in the chat in a second. There is a 50% off tickets for DroidCon London, which is in 2 weeks. You need to be in London, like it's physically there to attend. But I'll be there, and you get stickers. Stickers! That's an envelope full of stickers.
Stickers.
Which...
Nice, because we had also the discount code for Berlin, right? But they were
I don't
nine.
Know if they're all
they were like
taken.
Only nine.
I don't know.
Gone. Let's
put that one in.
The,
just get free shit, people. The... Stop complaining. Well, nobody's complaining, but
yeah, it's, I like. Ugo is actually saying it. You know, it's giveaways with Italians. That's the thing. Because why bother? I mean, we have this stuff for you. We asked it for you, and now you get it. DroidCon, what is it? Berlin. Yes, let's make it in real life. Boom. So I don't know if the Berlin one is still valid because they were like finite number. Finite, how is it in English? I'm brain fart. Anyway, they were like just 9.
Yeah. So there's 5 for London.
Like a glitter jacket.
5 for London, 9 for Berlin. First come, first serve. Use those. And I hope to see you people in London. Seriously. I would love to. And that said, I think we have another, let's say, 10, 15 minutes before we wrap it up and do the announcement.
Yeah.
Let's do this screen here, which will not necessarily give us a variable for now, but it will definitely give us a root name. So, Mark, are you okay with a root name?
That works. I think
absent
it works.
Absent friends. I think that's appropriate for this route. Okay. So let's say we go to our top level navigation. We have our composable here, and we need to create a new one. So in the settings graph, there's a licenses screen. And I need to create that. Da-da-da. And it's gonna be absent friends. Okay, Mark. There you go. That's done. And now we need to create the licenses screen.
Hello, the tracks.
Oh, hello. Welcome. The tracks, if you missed it, or anyone that is joining now, we have just put some discount codes for London and Berlin in the chat. It's 50% off for both of them. So I haven't managed to find a ticket for London. I'm sorry, but at least you have 50% off if you want. So there's that. What else we've done? We have put scaffolding on the screen, finally. It doesn't look like utter shit. I mean, it looked like very nicely animated utter shit, but still. Oh, I think we also need to fix the padding on this one. Yeah, we'll do it in a second. Now what we want to do is make something show up when someone clicks acknowledgements, like, and show the licenses list instead of, you know, exploding the app, which is not very fun, very nice to do. So there was a to-do somewhere. Maybe it was here. Yeah, it's here. So that and also goes here. This is settings graph. This is licenses. Okay, and we need to create that function. Yes. This is internal and it's a composable and also goes in its own file. Okay, yep, good. And now this should not crash the app anymore. Hey, thank you for the cheers. The app looks so good, looks like part of the US. I mean, thank you, but not really. Like, it could be much better.
Yeah. He just wants a ticket.
Yeah.
He's trying. The apps look so cool. So nice. You're great people. If I find a ticket, I'm going to give it to you. But it's okay. I get it.
Jokes aside, there's Mr. Gero. That was asking in the chat what we are developing. We are working on an application for, I like to call it digital well-being. The idea behind this app is that you don't want to be constantly distracted by notifications. What you want to do is you want your notifications hidden from you, and just you get all the notifications shown to you at a specific time. So every 15 minutes or every hour or whatever. So that's what we are building. And part of the functionality is there already. Like you can see, we are getting the notifications. We have an archive of all the past notifications, which is not very many on this emulator, to be honest, but that's fine. There's also, like we have a swipe to snooze thing, so we can snooze notification, but I think there's something broken.
Well, but at least we have a nice, nice error.
Yeah,
message.
It's fair. I don't know why it doesn't. I thought we had that, but I probably broke it and forgot to fix it. Whatever, that's fine. Yep.
Yeah, that's. I knew that the sound thing, it will actually at some point bite us, but yeah, they are very
crashy.
On point, so thank you. Really.
Why does it crash?
Ouch. What are you?
Oh,
are you
casting
a string to obviously. Oh, no, it's crashing because it works. Looks like it seems
progress.
Yeah. I you know, it's okay when it crashes because it works. That's nice.
You are watching a
and by the way, this yes. Things like this, you know, that you like forget because you have this to-do created automatically by IntelliJ when you create like a class or, you know, a method or things like that. It happens, especially if you're not working with pull requests or things like that, if you're working alone on one of your pet projects, that you can forget about that. You know, they slip through the cracks more often than I will like that I like to admit. Things like this, they get they surface like constantly when I run those robot tests, right? Because the thing is going through the app and is clicking everywhere. So eventually it's gonna click on that action menu item or like that button or like the about section that you never finished. And you are gonna get the Crashlytic notification because, you know, I was like, oh my God, the app is crashing. You check it and then there is, oh, it's not yet implemented. They're like, oh, now I remember. Bravo, Robotest. So, you know, it's the small things that help you, especially if you're an indie developer. So if you're working with a team, probably you have other people, you know, covering your six. But if you're working alone, it's nice to have help from a tool.
Okay, I'm confused why this one became a Boolean. But sure.
Well, I mean, Mr. Gero, I am probably butchering your nick, but something interesting, you are a web developer, something interesting that you can actually look is Compose for web. So you will probably be able to retain some of the information that you see on the stream and apply to web as well. So, yeah. You know.
Although, if they're learning Java, maybe there's a couple of steps in the middle, like learning Kotlin. In general, though,
definitely.
Mr. Gero, I don't know. I would recommend that you try to learn Kotlin instead of Java. First of all, because some stuff is easier to do, is like much easier to do than in Java. Not just in terms of the language itself, but also in terms of the standard library. There are so many more things that are already done for you in Kotlin that in Java you would have to go constantly on Stack Overflow and see like how do you read a file, like stuff like that. That in Kotlin is there. It's just a method call and it's done. It's also more concise language and more modern, I would say. Although Java is catching up, mostly by implementing the same things that Kotlin implemented a few years back. But
I mean, if you're, thank you. I mean, if you're running things like, you know, Java 16 or 17, that's pretty decent already. On Android, we were stuck on Java like 1995. How was it? Like Java 1.7,
I think, whatever. Realistically speaking.
It was a very obsolete language. I mean, it was okay at the time. It was not okay 5 years ago. So thank God for Kotlin. And nowadays, Kotlin is opening a lot of opportunities when I look around how to build something, you know, if I need to build, well, of course, Android apps, that's a given. Desktop app, I love it because I can run Kotlin and Compose on desktop. Backend, I'm also doing Ktor and Kotlin stuff. Look at that.
Beautiful. Design.
But now, after the design, yeah, yes, much, much fancy. After the chat that we had with
which of the ones
okay. with Jake,
which of the ones I was saying?
Hmm? Yeah, the chat that we had with Jake the other day, I'm very, very curious about mm-hmm. Mosaic. You know, I want to check how, you know, I'm actually spoiler, I'm ruining the surprise, but I wanted to build Mosaic UI for your deep clean script. I wanted it to be a surprise that you get like a pull request out of the blue, but it would be nice because it's a project that I love, that I use. I mean, again, more often than I would like to admit, and always makes me very happy. And I have the GIF from Aliens with Ripley that says "nuke them from the orbit." That's the way I. But I wonder if we could fit like a Mosaic UI on that thing, and I will. Oh yeah, let's give also a link. Haven't we built a license screen in the past? I think we build the menu, but not the screen itself.
I did build a license screen that I actually really liked this app. It was actually I'll be honest, I'm biased because I created it, but I actually think it's one of the best license screens I've ever seen. Not that it takes much, because it's generally just an HTML file that people are like, yeah, whatever, fuck it. But this actually had some designs to it. So there's that. Yeah.
Show me the design. Show me the design. It's the best I made it. Yes, Hugo, that's exactly it.
Oh no, I need to sign in. I cannot.
So the
I can get the
question that I have.
Oh man, this is fucking old. Woo.
APK. Yeah, there's an APK. It's 4 years
that's
ago.
Been a
wow,
long time
basically
ago.
That's like last century. But is it gonna
probably
be able to install it? But
question mark?
How do you get the list of licenses?
Yeah.
Was it like a manual process or did you? Okay, so because I always looked for some automatic thing, you know, like grepping Gradle and things like that.
I think it's broken.
The fuck is this?
Yeah. Because it needs to check for network, because there was some weird bugs with Firebase where it would just essentially explode. But yeah.
Ciao. It's not that.
I can pick another release, I guess. Oh, no. Probably the backend has been taken down. That's the problem.
Jake made a thing.
The backend is not active anymore.
Ciao.
But I guess.
Yeah, that's fair. Crash app license. Let's see. Because is it How is it working?
Okay. Let's see.
A Gradle plugin, which... It's a Gradle plugin.
But it is the licenses of your dependency graph, match what you expect. Or fills. Yeah, but this is only telling you if you have licenses that you don't expect. First of all, you need to know which licenses you want, which not everyone does. And second of all, this doesn't tell you, I think. Like, it doesn't generate... Oh, no, it generates this, so you can still do that, I guess.
It also export.
Yeah, it does export it to our artifacts.json file. Well, I guess maybe we can do this. Yeah, well, not now.
Yeah, give it a shot.
We have 5 minutes and we need to wrap it up. But,
open a ticket. Oh, but this is not maintained anymore.
What is this one?
Is it going to work?
It's...
I know. I mean, there was a banner.
No, but that's
there was a
squanchy.
Banner at
that's,
the top.
That's the app that I was archived.
Ah, shit.
Yeah.
Your Google Chrome sorry. Is too much for me.
But
from a UI point of view, I mean, we're building it in Compose, so
I don't
think
remember.
It's going
to... Yeah, there's not much you can reuse, unfortunately.
Reuse. No. But I mean, we tried, and we are sure that your license screen was the best screen.
It was nice, I have to say. But I don't remember where the fuck is stuff. So it was in the about screen. There you go. So well, obviously there's a recycler view. But
recycler view.
Yeah, it was manual, but it was typed, which was good.
This is a manual too.
I don't think at the time there was much. In this sense that you could use, and then it has a recycler view. It's it was grouping things by license and whatnot. It was expandable, which wasn't a very common thing back then. So yeah, I liked it because not just because I made it, but also because it was actually looked
RX.
Nice. And I didn't design the app, so there's that.
RX Lind.
Yep.
RX Lind.
I don't know.
Rings a bell. I mean, can you search for RX Lind?
I heard RX Lind is great, but I didn't do it. It was great regardless of the fact that I didn't do it.
Yeah.
Little robots.
Okay.
Who might that
person?
Be? Oh, is that you, Hugo?
Oh, look at that. Oh my God, look at how small the world is, right? Yeah, that's a very tiny world. Oh, look at that. If you start, what a coincidence. Yes.
I mean, where's the
probably the whole industry. the whole industry. I mean, the more I work on Android, the more I'm suspicious that it's just like 10 of us. You know, it's like, it's just 10 of us. Oh my God!
No,
I like it. No. Oh my God!
I'm the owner of the project, so I can ignore the template. Please don't do this.
Wow! Not even nothing. Just the
yeah.
Thing.
Whatever. I know what it means. It's for me. I know what it means.
Yeah. Sure.
Definitely. Anyway, I think it's time to wrap things up because it's almost 8, and we don't want to delay the VOD. So, wrapping things up very quickly.
Go.
We are done for today. We'll see you on Sunday with Mark, and from Wednesday. Every 2 weeks on Wednesdays, we are going to be having a spin-off series, which we affectionately and probably permanently at this point call Design with the Italians, that is going to be people from mostly from Google, as far as I remember, and mostly from the material design team, explaining the basics of designs for developers that don't know anything how to design. People that can code well, but cannot design well.
No, that design at all. People like me. Don't point that. That's just unfair. So the reasoning behind it was like, I want to get better at things like how to use colors, how to use typography, how to balance measurements and size of elements. So for a few weeks, we are gonna run this joint venture with friends from Google, and they are gonna try very hard to teach me how to properly design apps. I am the baseline, so if they can get results with me, it's gonna be like a walk in the park for normal people. And I can't wait. And
you're a publishing house now with multiple titles. I mean, we're even running a book club, apparently. Yeah, by the way, get that book. It's really good. We're not even going to post the affiliate link at this point. But
yeah, just get the book.
Yeah.
We don't care.
Speaking of books, it's midway through October. If you haven't gotten the Compose Internals book for free, you still have a couple of weeks to do that. Do that. It's probably great. I haven't read it, but it's probably great because we know the people that have worked on it are really, really good. So I expect it to be very, very good. And we'll have the author with us at some point. You will see Chet next week in Berlin. Well, say hi to Chet from us. I am going to see him in London. How to get it? I think you just go to the link that Ivan posted in the chat.
Yeah.
And
you should be able to get it for free because I want to actually give them credit. Snap Mobile actually sponsored the book.
Thanks, Alan. Thanks, Ivani.
Compose. So for the whole, it's basically whole October. The book is gonna be free thanks to Snap Mobile. So if you want to give them a shout on Twitter, please do.
Yes.
And
also
we also have
Ioani and Al from Snap Mobile as guests in one of our slices, like the third one. And I'm going to put the link in the chat. So with Al and Ioani, where we talked about automotive. So if you're at all interested in Android automotive, so Android Auto, Android Automotive OS, cars, any intersection of those, then it was a really interesting discussion with them, like a chat that we had, and they explained, because they work in that world, they explain how it works, like what are the differences between Android Auto, Android Automotive OS, how it works, like how you create an application for those platforms. And on top of that, we also discussed how you can run Android Automotive OS on a tablet, because they've also done that. So you can pretend you have a fancy car, but just like gluing a tablet to your Fiat Punto or something.
Nice. So, but that's actually the best part for, you know, people are like a bit tinkering with this kind of stuff, because if you have a they are running it on a old Samsung Tab S5, because the idea behind is that, you know, the hardware that you are going to find on the car is going to be 2 or 3 years old no matter what. So if you today have a couple of years old tablet, you can actually flash it. They already have like a ready to go.
Don't spoil too much.
ROM for the S5. Go for it. Go for it. Go for
yeah,
it.
Yeah, the nerds gonna contrary be nerds, to our usual torrents of words that last a couple of hours, generally, like all the those four recorded slices things, they don't last much. They last around half an hour, 45
yeah,
minutes
like
tops.
Half an hour or
so,
whatever, yeah.
It's an easier it's an easier thing to digest casually. Okay, I think that's all for today. We'll see you on Sunday with Mark.
Yes.
And I will see you on Wednesday with the first design episode. As a reminder, in 2 weeks, yes, in 2 weeks, I will be in DroidCon London. If you're going to DroidCon London, yeah. See you there. Flag me down. I will have stickers. I have about 50 of them. So first 50-ish people that find me will get a sticker from me. Well, make it 48. I'm going to keep two for myself because I don't have any other for now. And and then, yeah, I'll see you there. Don't forget, we posted like discount links in the chat earlier. So you can go
yes.
back and find them. Even we'll make sure they're also in the description on YouTube.
In the description, yes.
And this is a wink, wink, even it's your time to do the YouTube thing.
Yes, I'm going to do the YouTube thing, but I also want to remind everybody that we are going to have a break because when Sebastian is in London, we
yes.
are going to have like a couple of episodes off. So just be aware that you're off the hook for a couple of a couple of episodes. So from a just wrapping up point of view, again, thank you for being with us and messing with us in the chat. Your support is incredible. If you have an Amazon Prime subscription, you can support the channel for free. Just link your Amazon and your Twitch account, and then you can click on the subscribe button on Twitch and you will see subscribe with Prime. You don't pay anything. We get a couple of dollars and we buy mostly stickers.
Well, only stickers so far.
Well, mostly stickers because, yeah, the budget is, yeah, I mean, return of investment of buying tickets it's the most effective for us at the moment. And we are going to ship them, you know, the giveaway, we are shipping them for free all around the world. So please support us. If you are watching this on YouTube, please subscribe, like, and also turn on the notification. We have a pretty stable schedule, but the notification help us. If you enable the notification, the YouTube algorithm actually helps the channel. So it's not more like it's not for you, it's for us. So yeah, and yeah. So this is basically VOD. Today's VOD is gonna be as usual. The giveaway for IntelliJ license. So when the VODs drops tomorrow, we are gonna put the word on the on Twitter. So follow us on Twitter, and you will see the VOD link and the word that you have to put in the comments, and you will be able to join the giveaway for the IntelliJ Ultimate 100% discount code that we are giving away weekly. So IntelliJ, great thing. You can use it for Compose for desktop. Yay.
You can also use
and
the
in
license
a few weeks
that you get to use code with
yes.
me on Android Studio. So also if you want to pair with someone, that's
yeah.
really good. So just a reminder.
Yes. So, and that's it. It's
yep.
I mean, this is it. Keep an eye for the links in the description for the discount codes for DroidCon. Thank you again for DroidCon for the free tickets and the discounts code. And what else?
We're done.
I think we're done for today.
It's time for dinner, I think. See you all.
It was a pleasure.
See you all on Sunday.
Beautiful people.
Bye.
Beautiful people. Ciao, ciao. Have a nice evening.
Bye-bye.